Can you really have an on-premise private cloud? Hi, I'm Ron Hogue. In the last two videos, we looked at the question, can a private cloud really exist? In the last video, we looked at the NIST definition for cloud computing and discussed on-demand self-service. In this video, I want to continue looking at cloud characteristics and discuss resource pooling and rapid elasticity. As we continue this discussion, I want us to think about these concepts in light of having an on-premise private cloud, or in other words, a private cloud that we have in our own data center or in our own building. When we look at resource pooling, it mentions the provider's computing resources are pooled to serve multiple consumers using a multi-tenant model. And I want to stop there. Are we serving multiple consumers or multiple tenants, multiple users of the same environment in a private cloud model? One might argue, no, that we don't, because it's all one organization. Continuing on, it says, with different physical and virtual resources dynamically assigned and reassigned according to consumer demand. As mentioned earlier, we can assign and reassign resources according to a web interface that allows us to do that. The second part of resource pooling says there's a sense of location independence in that the customer generally has no control or knowledge over the exact location of the provided resources, but may be able to specify a location at a higher level of abstraction, like it's in a certain country or a certain state or a certain data center. Now, this is where the conflict begins with private cloud versus public cloud. Here it says, if a customer generally has no control or knowledge over the exact location, well, that's not true at all. In the case of a private cloud, you do have exact knowledge and the exact location of your resources. You know what server room it's in, what rack it's in, and what server might be running your virtual machine at any given point. So in this last part of resource pooling, we see a direct conflict with what we understand as a private cloud. Let's now turn our attention over to rapid elasticity. It says, capabilities can be elastically provisioned and released, in some cases automatically, to scale rapidly outward and inward, commensurate with demand. To the consumer, the capabilities available for provisioning often appear to be unlimited and can be appropriated in any quantity at any time. When we consider a private cloud environment, we know exactly the limitations of our virtual environment. We purchased a specific number of servers to allow for a specific number of virtual hosts to be on that environment. In this case, provisioning is not unlimited or anywhere near unlimited. Again, when we talk about unlimited for the case of public, we're thinking that it appears to be unlimited, that if I just need more, I can purchase more. But clearly, in the case of a private cloud, it is not an unlimited amount of resources that we can appropriate. In fact, in most cases, we purchase an exact amount to meet a specific demand. Come back for the last video in this series where we examine metered service and we'll summarize our findings. If this is good stuff, like it, tweet it, subscribe it, and share it. I'm Ron Hogue. I'll see you in the next video.